Well, hello. Today
we're going to be talking about the fuel distribution system on one of those CIS cars, the Volkswagen. Early 80s had these things, and they would have a tendency to have issues. So what goes wrong with these? Well, what happens is the fuel pin on this thing will seize up. So this is supposed to move back and forth freely. So this one, it didn't have that many kilometers on it, but anyways, it was sticking. So they just have a tendency to get rusted and start sticking. This one, see how it springs right back? So this goes right in that area, and the vacuum from the engine is what controls how much fuel is metered to with the use of this pin. So what happens is, with time, it'll rust and seize in the same position if you don't start it up and drive this car. It's the worst thing for these cars is to not have them. I think this is like a shoulder to prevent it from coming actual out too far. But anyways, with the use of Croil and the use of a little bit of heat, I was able to free it back up again. So it's ready to be sent out to the customer and installed on the vehicle. But yeah, this is one of those things that you know, time is not on your side. It'll cause it to seize up and not work right. But anyways, I just wanted to show this. You can spray some penetrating fluid in there. I did in all of the fittings and let it soak for 24 hours and then come back to it. This one, just wanted to make sure that it was moving as it was supposed to, and it seems that freed right up. So anyways, hopefully this helps out somebody, but that's what you got to do is, if this is hanging upside down, it's got to move freely, and which it is working great. Now, I would not attempt to open this up. If you do that, you can get into some problems. There's like a spring in there, and yeah, you don't want to mess around with that. It's a big pain in the butt to set that all up. But anyways, hopefully this helps out somebody.